Manchu. Sorry, Manchu. Manchu, I'm in medical room. The doctor paper, bula ke leke aao.
Famously 2021-22 season, and we are back at the Capital Ground with the second game of the day, which is between Indian Arrows and PIFA Football Club. The side from Maharashtra will be taking on All India Football Federation's developmental side. And my name is Sohan Poddar, I'm your host, and I'm joined by Mr. Abhijit Paul, and he is the Executive Secretary of Odisha Football Association. Welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you.
Well, let's get started with the first question of the day. And my question is, how important do you think is a league structure for the development of the game in the country?
For the development of the football in the country, league is the most important championships. If a amount of teams and more days, more matches in the leagues will be organized, that will be the help for the development of the footballs.
And this season we are having an extended format of the Hero Indian Women's League with 12 teams. Your take on this, in what ways do you think it's going to help the players?
If this league will be restructures with better way, because the league is organized by All India Football Federations. The teams are changing every year. More that the old teams, if you go through the record of the IWLs, the champions the times of these leagues, they are not in this time leagues. So we have to restructure these leagues. We have to create the women's oriented football clubs in the country. Those who appoint these players, those who register their players for a full years, not for 2 months, 3 months, and giving them the payments for the years. So we have to, by the women's footballs, to restructure the leagues is paramount requirement. So I also talk to other stakeholder of this league is, because if you go this time, the powerhouse of the women's football, Manipur, no team from Manipur in the leagues. So sorry state of affairs, teams, every year the teams are changing. Team will come from the state championships. This is not the right way for the women's footballs. We have to give importance to footballs. We have a great chance to qualify for the World Cup of women's footballs. If we invest more and more on women's footballs, more and more on women's football, grassroots women's footballs, then very shortly, very 3-4 years, if we invest on them, we can play World Cup, because we have talents in my states. If you go through these leagues, my teams, Rising Student Clubs, who are the champions of the team, first editions, they are runners-up, and second edition, they are champions, and they also qualify for third editions. But last two elections, they are there. So if you concentrate on the women's clubs, those who are interested in women's football, that clubs, and give them chance for the women's IWLs.
And talking about the All India Football Federation introducing the Indian Arrows team in the Hero Indian Women's League this season, like we have the Arrows men's team in the I League. Your take on this move?
Yeah, good movement. If this Indian Arrows team is, because in the main we are getting a lot of players from the Indian Arrows to our SLI clubs. They are promoted to the SLI club. Good movement for the development of women's football, this Indian Arrows teams.
Well, Indian Arrows have had a wonderful season so far in their debut campaign, and let's have a look at their build-up to this particular tournament. The
Yeah, it's very important for the women's team. That's the first time we are playing the IWL. Basically, to form these arrows, one team is to, you know, the breeze, maybe a developmental team for the national team. And yeah, of course, playing with this IWL, they'll get, you know, 11 matches experience with this time. And the 11 match experience is a huge player for every player, so, you know, get the experience for to develop themselves as a player, a good player. So yeah, we'll get a time also to see the players, how they will perform against the different opponents. That's good for the players and for the team as well. Yeah, of course, because we are basically focusing on the under 21 girls only on this IWL, and we are trying to prepare these girls only. And so most of the girls, those who are good girls, they are gone for the exams, and we have brought new girls on the team. Yeah, these girls are showing their, you know, promising them, and they are working very, very hard to get into the team also. That's always a positive sign for as a coach and for as a player also, you know, develop themselves as a good player. It's always good to have experience and, you know, good international players on the team, because we have two senior girls who already joined the senior women's team, and they came back with a high, you know, high note, and so the girls are very happy to see them on the squad, and these girls are guiding these young players a lot, and this is always a, you know, positive sign for them. I always, you know, prefer the young girls to follow the football. They watch football and they learn football. They always try to put their effort and just try to be, you know, show their talents on their talents and, you know, come to the national team, work hard and make their names, you know, the fame. Now the sport is, you know, is a livelihood also. See, I'm just focusing on their, you know, development and prospects. These girls are developing every day, and as the tournament progresses, I'll look into these girls in the progressive development. I'm looking to these girls as a progressive development, and hopefully at the end of the tournament I want to see these girls play a good football.
Well, lots of youngsters emerging through this Indian Arrows project. We saw that when it comes to the men's team, expecting a similar sort of scenario with the women's team as well, sir.
Yes. So we think we have a great opportunity from this. The All India Football gave a great opportunity to these young girls in Indian Arrows teams. We have a great hope that these girls can do better in the futures, and they are grooming years. In the coming days, they can play for other big clubs up Indian.
Well, Odisha government doing a wonderful job in recent times, in culmination with the Odisha Football Association in providing the infrastructural aids to all the participating teams in the Hero Indian Women's League. How important is the role of a government? How does it work as a moral booster for the teams and players, you think?
The Football Association of Odisha is very much thankful to our Honorable Chief Minister, Shri Naveen Patnaik. He is totally dedicated to the sports, not only for the football, other sports also. And we are very much thankful to Mr. Vinil Krishna sir, who is the sports secretary, and the entire sports departments. They are backing all the sports, and particular to the footballs. They are helping in every way, and in the infrastructure wise, and player and other promotion wise, that how the team will play, how the players will get better opportunities, better support. They are supporting every times, everywhere, wherever we are going with any suggestions, any for the any help for the football associations. They are giving full cooperation to that, and once again we are very much thankful to them. And this way we are planning with the government of Odisha and football associations are planning for the coming days more and more football, especially in women footballs. Mr. Vinil Krishna is very much interested on women's footballs, because we have a great record of women's football. We have a lot of players of Indian teams, for the Indian teams.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, you can carry on, sir.
Hello.
Yeah, you are audible.
Yes. Odisha has produced lot of women's footballers in future, and coming days also we are going to produce more and more women's football for the country. So we hope with the support of government of Odisha and the technical support of All India Football Federations, we can go far and we can give better the women's football in India.
Well, talking about the Odisha Women's League prevailing for a longer duration now, throw some light on how it helped in terms of producing more players from this particular state.
Yes, if the players will play more matches, they will show their performance better. And we are also planning for 17 leagues in the month of July or August. We are planning to start this under-17 leagues. We government of Odisha and Football Association are planning to do in under-17 women's leagues. And it's also a more than 1 month league we are planning for that. So if the teams, more and more teams will come and more matches will be played, players will be from that.
What are the steps of upgradation to be imposed by the Odisha Football Association in the near future?
Pardon?
What are the steps of upgradation? Am I audible?
Yes, we are saying that we are going to start under-17 girls leagues for the young girls, which was planning by All India Football Federations. We have received mail from them also. They are also planning for under-17 championships, under-17 leagues. We also planning for that. We have already circulated this year to all the stakeholders of Football Association of Odisha, and government is also very much interested for that. And for the grassroots, for the women's football, so we are planning lot of activities for the grassroots of football of women's in Odisha also.
Well, the support of Odisha government has been immense to all the sports. Talking about football in particular, there are two teams, Odisha Sports and Odisha Police, playing in the current edition of the Hero Indian Women's League. Rising Students were the champions of the second edition. How was this transformation or growth possible?
Yes, because we are working in football since long, because last 15, 20 years we have players like Sardanjali Samantarai, who was the captain of this women's team for three four years. We have Sasmita Malli, we have a women's coach who was the coach, champion coach of SAP champions in the 2008 to 2011. He was the senior Indian women's team, Ahmad Said Jabbar. He was the coach of Indian women's team. So we have a passionate on women's football because a lot of girls are getting chance because government of Odisha, Odisha Police, those who are playing for the India team, and if they are getting the medal from the national champions, they are directly get jobs from the Odisha Police Department. So lot of thing is happening in Odisha for the betterment of the football, betterment of the sports. Government is doing excellent jobs. Other stakeholders who are involved with the folds, they are also doing for the betterment of football. They are also working. We are hoping that in the coming days, we will produce more and more players to the Indian women's teams.
What do you make of the performance of Odisha Police and Odisha Sports in the ongoing edition of the Hero Indian Women's League?
Yes, Sports Odisha is doing good, and Odisha Police also doing not so bad. They are also doing up to their up to our expectations. But what we have in the team like Rising Student do in the first two editions, I think in the next couple of years, we again be the champion of the Indian Women's Leagues. And when we are playing with the two teams, more and more players are getting chance to play more and more matches. So it's a good move. I am very much thankful to All India Football Federation. They are giving chance to two teams to participate in this championships. Once again, thanks to I-League Department, IW, and All India Football Federations.
Please tell us about the grassroots level development which is prevailing in the state of Odisha at present.
Yes, we have it. We have because government are also having two sports hostels, women's foot sports hostels, where the girls are staying for the throughout 12 throughout the years and playing there. They have a coaches now. They are excellent center. Now they have an excellent center at Bhubaneswar also, and Fodolands or Odisha also. In the other districts, we are also start grassroots level footballs. Baby leagues are there. So we are planning for the futsals, women's futsals in the coming days after the IWLs. We are planning for futsals, women's futsals in our places. So lot of things we are planning for the women development of women's footballs. Football Assurance Odisha and Government of Odisha are very much hopeful that coming days we will do better in the Indian Women's Leagues.
Well, now talking about the national team, as we all know, with the under 17 FIFA World Cup is at the horizon, the camp for which already started in Jamshedpur under Thomas Denneby. How important this mega event going to be for country's women football?
Now, this is a big event. Everyone is dreaming to play World Cup. So when World Cup is organized in India, our girls are able to play in World Cups, but camp which is going on at Jamshedpur, the players and the coach is very big coach. This Mr. Denberry. We have a very hope on them, on him, that he can do something better for our country. Our girls are training under him for last 3-4 months. They are under him. Scouting is the problem because no national championship was held for the last 3 years for these groups. Because from where they are getting these 30 girls, it's very because the players, if scouting from the championship is different, and the scouting of the players from just through the practice or any other competitions, it is different. So we have some on the scouting of the players, but after all, when these 30 girls are going under Mr. Denberry, we are hope that this team will do better in the coming World Cup.
Talking about, this is the last question before I end this. Odisha will be hosting the SAF Under 20 Championship in the month of July with matches to be played at the Kalinga Stadium. Is it another feather in the cap for Odisha government and the Football Association?
Yes, we are. Government of Odisha is hosting more and more international championships. So we are hopeful that Government of Odisha, along with the Football Association Odisha, will successfully host under 20 SAF championships because Government of Odisha is very much expertise on hosting the world class championship, because in the future we are hosting Hockey World Cup. Now today Grand Prix is going on. On 24th there is the Asian Athletic Grand Prix is there. So throughout the years, Government of Odisha with other sports associations, they are organizing a lot of international and national championship, and we hope that this under 20 SAF championship will be a grand success.
Well, that brings us to the end of our pre-match discussion. Thank you so much, sir, for your time.
Thank you.
It's coming your way.
Well, after a fine start to the season, Indian Arrows have felt the foes of unpredictability of the Hero Indian Women's League, and they face off against PIFA Sports Club, who have made it a habit to put a spanner in the works of big teams. And today, a storied rivalry sees another chapter, and as usual, Arrows are the ones who need all 3 points to continue with their quest to enter the top 3. And well, the Blue Tigress making their way out of the team bus, and they will be eyeing for full 3 points this evening against a plucky Epifa side, a side not to be taken for granted, otherwise lightning could strike in broad daylight. And making their Hero Indian Women's League debut this season, the Indian Arrows sojourn in the top tier club competition of the country has gone from better to good. However, eyeing for full 3 points this evening. Finishing runners-up in their debut season would be a dream starter for the Indian Arrows, and in their bid to turn back the clock to myriad days, the team management has turned to Suren Chhetri as the Arrows made their debut under his guidance and under a new head coach. And having a young squad, the Indian Arrows have got new players on board too, and together they must see this though looking as much upward as possible. Well, the head coach Suren Chhetri echoed before the clash. Let's hear from the man himself.
Yeah, team are good. Playing 9 matches, a good experience for the girls. The girls are doing good.
And what do you make of your opponents, PIFA, today?
Yeah, PIFA is just a good side. They are in the 6th position now. We are in 4th. Yeah, today's game is very important for me.
Well, this is the Indian Arrows lineup, and Suresh makes no changes from the side which beat ARAFC 4 days ago. Adrija in goal, Muskan, Priyanka Devi and Martina make up the midfield three. And there are starts for Arti and Sunita as well, as he looks to find the right balance for this one. As Apurna Nursery continues to get into the team, but it is that midfield of Martina and Priyanka which will want to raise control in the middle of the park. And Apurna and Priyanka are the joint top scorers of the side with 9 goals each. Well, the head coach Suren Chhetri has seen kickstart Setu Madurai and Gokulam Kela all overtake his side, but that gap can be bridged with 3 points tonight, but it will not come easy. His counterpart will see to that. Well, the potential debutants on the bench for the Arrows, Vananjana Thapa, Shanmuga Priya, they all hope to get some minutes as the head coach gets their players back up to speed. Well, PIFA have tried to set the bar higher this season for the lads in the team. In recent debut season, the expectation is different. Had a month to prepare, and they knew how difficult it was for all players and their girls. And the team is really young, and it is a huge challenge. They look sharp and are very confident this year, and can see a lot of surprises this evening in their gameplay. And they are looking forward to the season and how it is going to shape them for their future endeavors, with only last 2 fixtures remaining, as they aim to prepare these girls for the upcoming international matches. As every game that passes by, the players are gaining more game time, which is really very important. And well, the head coach Nirvan Shah spoke to us about his plans for this evening.
The team shaping quite well. We had a win last game, so everyone's positive.
And how do you plan to take on your opponents today?
We're going to continue playing the way we play. We're just going to keep pressing.
Well, PIFA, they have put up a very decent team for this particular clash. We saw glimpses of what PIFA players can do. And they welcome another one today in Payal. And she starts in place of Anjali in goal. And the other two, Aku and Zairem, all starts against a team which they troubled in the past. And Nicelia was an ever-present first name on the team sheet kind of a player, and continues to lead the lines. Nicelia earlier scored a winner against Odisha Police. Well, this team can cause enough trouble for the Indian Arrows, and Nirvan Shah going with a 4-4-2. And it is a win that PIFA and Nirvan Shah badly need, and that win in the last game remains the highlight of the season for them. But it hasn't been a build-on. A lot of praiseworthy performances individually for Lalnun Siami Nicelia, with all the hustle and bustle all over the pitch. Well, the referee for today's game is Kanika Burman, and she is going to be assisted by Basudev Pal and Srijata Palit. The fourth official is Snigdha Mondal and match commissioner Sudhir Menon. We're in Dinero's fourth at present with a game in hand, and could go above kickstart to third with a win this evening. And chance for PIFA to reach to 14 points if they beat Arrows this evening. You can look at the bench. The points table, it's mercurial and volatile. And the championship race is basically going to be between Gokulam Kerala and Setu Madurai. Both the teams with 27 points each. They've won all the matches so far. Gokulam have scored 56 goals, Setu Madurai 36. Gokulam also conceding a goal less than Sethu Madurai. Both of the sides will be in action tomorrow. Alwen Sanghi, she is on the bench, and Lalrin Muani as well, an option that has always been called upon time and again. But PIFA, with only one win in six games, they need all the firepower today as well. And the teams have gone above them now, and they have to catch up. And of course, they have that game in hand to make the most of it. But the thing is, these two teams always provide entertainment, and it is important that they don't get sucked into that habit, as Nirvan Shah will be as happy with a 1-0 as he will be with a 3-2. PIFA, they are 6th. They managed to collect 11 points from 9 games. They've won 3 matches, drew 2 and lost 4. Arrows, on the flip side, they've won 6 out of total 9. And they have lost 2 matches and drew 1. They collected 19 points. A win will take them just a point clear of 3rd placed Kickstart Football Club. And that is going to be their mission for now. And after that, lost into the hands of Gokulam Kerala, they defeated Mata Rukmani by 8-0. Priyanka Devi scoring 4 goals. Apurna with a brace. Sunita also scoring a brace. In the last game though, they defeated Ara FC of Gujarat by 3-1 with goals from Apurna, Muskan and Priyanka Devi. Well, Kanika Burman with the two skippers, Muskan of Indian Arrows and Karen Pius, the number 8 here. She was the hero of the match in the last game against Odisha Police. She will continue to lead the line and partner alongside Lalnun Siami, the number 9. Muskan Subha will be sitting deep in midfield and provide that protective screen in front of the back four alongside Martina. And so Indian Arrows also with a better record, with 3 wins in the last 4 games, and 2 sides which have tasted victory in a while will be hopefully producing another scintillating game of football. All of which means that the Indian Arrows have beaten ARAFC in their first attempts. But that record won't matter. It won't play in the heads of any players, because in sport one must look ahead, especially at those on the pitch. And Indian Arrows will have to look not just ahead, even above them. And up to the table, and of teams in front of them, 3 points will take them above Kickstart, as I've mentioned, and gives the Hero Indian Women's League table a wonderful 2020, a vision and a static that even Suren Chetri, the part-time pilot, will appreciate. What a game we have on our hands. Now, this is, of course, match number 57 in the Hero Indian Women's League, and we approach towards the business end of the season, with 9 more matches remaining after this. And the Gokulam Kerala and Sethu Madurai encounter going to be the big one on Judgment Day, a 7:30 p.m. kickoff from the Kalinga Stadium. And these two teams will be looking to finish as high as possible in the points table. Arrows will be targeting the top 3 spot and give a tough fight to kickstart. And they want that pressure to be maintained on the side from Bangalore.
Seconds left.
And so Martin Athakcham Muskan are in the starting 11 for Arrows, and the latter, of course, impressing so far this season in the Hero Indian Women's League. And Priyanka Devi, more the league goes, better than any other player. She scored 9 goals along with Apurna Nurjari. One an attacking midfielder, the other one is the box striker. Let's see what the striking duo can produce this evening, though, as both the teams taking in on each other in the back of wins. And we're off then with the second game of the day at the Capital Ground. And there's been always a surprising fading of form from PIFA after a good start. And has the team stopped playing well is the question? No, not entirely. But seems like the others have caught on. When you are a new side, the other head coaches will sit keen-eyed, hatching schemes and finding out where it hurts them the most. Suren Chetri, almost always neat and nifty, immaculate and uncluttered aura of arranged, believes in his plans, his style, his system, his ways and his methods. Will that work is the question. On the other side, Irvan Shah, he knows how to beat Arrows. What a challenge that will be. An early free kick delivered inside the Arrows box. It's cleared. Falls for Aku, shot from distance. She'll get another bite at the cherry. Muskan Subha with a very vital block. And here is the thing, when you have a two young squad, you become the target. And now they need to sharpen their claws. The Arrows do. And the hunted must hunt down the point, the top spot in the Hero Indian Women's League. As Indian Arrows against PIFA. Let's hope for a cracker of an encounter. Muskan. Laldon Siami going down. It's going to be an interesting battle between the two number nines in the middle of the park, and Martina, her presence, gonna make a whole lot of difference. And Arrows will look to take control in midfield early on. Apurna Nurjari, not the greatest of the touches. Zairem, she's done well so far in her advanced role in midfield. Nisilia is the side's top goal scorer. Likes to operate from the left hand side. Lalun Siami will be taking that central role, and Karen will be playing just off the shoulder of the number 9. This is Permila, the right full back, with the throw in. Puts in a cross. Priyanka Devi with the attempt. No power on that. It was a weak try from the number 10. This shape looks just put up by the Arrows. It's a very much 4-1-3-2. There's the first attempt on goal from Aarti. It's flashed wide for a goal kick. As I was talking about the system, it's attack oriented. And the variation of that could be a 4-4-2 that allows high pressure and attacking in the final third. However, the 4-1-3-2 also has drawbacks, like its vulnerability to quick counters and attacks in the flank. And Aku from deep spreads it out wide and away from Nongbet. All the football fans have set high hopes on this Indian Arrows team. Even the men's teams have failed to finish into the top 4 in the I-League. The women's are setting an example here. And that is much, much better from the team in blue. There's Martina. She will be blocking all the loose balls, intercepting it. She can read the game. And that physical presence in front of the back four provides a lot of breathing time, breathing space to the likes of Santosh and Shashi Kumar. Martina again, this time caught in possession. Lalnoon Siami. She scampers away with the ball. Is sent into the box. Straight to the keeper though. Suddenly the pace of the game has picked up with PIFA pressing high. Arrows quite comfortably playing it out from defense. Losing out to Lalnoon Siami was Martina. Threading it along the floor. To the left of goal, Karen Pius. Support comes in from Lalnoon Siami. It's a good cross towards the far post. Martina was present. And Bhagyashree from distance. Out for a goal kick. Good signs early on from PIFA. A sharp start from the team in red. And that's a very poor giveaway. And Nongbet, Lalnoon Siami. Pushpa Rani in front of her. Aarti looking for options, looking for space. Plays it behind to Santosh. She will go long. A flick on from Apurna Nursery. And there's the right full back, Parmila. She loves joining attack on the overlap. Scored in the previous game, the game before against Mata Rukmani. Mansi into the feet of Karen. And there's the deflection. Aku winning the 50-50, riding the challenge. It's a wonderful pass, a lot of space to exploit. Adrija takes control of the situation. She's quickly off. This is Aku looking impressive early on. And PIFA finding space. A good save from the goalkeeper. Nisilia can capitalize on the second ball straight to the keeper. She almost scored from a similar sort of situation against Odisha Police. And that was an absolute curler from the edge of the area with her left foot. More of that will be required for PIFA this evening. These are the couple of chances for PIFA. The first one, a keeper somehow getting there. He rushed out Adrija. And Nisilia was ready to capitalize on the loose ball. A shot went straight to the keeper. Managing to backtrack at the right time and protecting her goal. It's a highly offensive system from the Arrows. It only has one defensive midfielder. As with the most formation, it does not typically look like a straight line across. And many teams play with central defensive midfielders and right midfielder, left midfielder, center attacking midfielder, which looks like a midfield diamond. A central attacking midfielder is sometimes referred as a false nine. Because they often move forward to join the forward line. This allows the central attacking midfielder to go higher up the pitch during the attack. Still having the security of double pivot behind her. Yet to impose themselves in midfield, the Arrows. All those 50-50 battles are being won by PIFA in the first 10 minutes. We saw in the first match of the day as well. and how Odisha Police making a bright start, but SSB are fighting back, and the game eventually ending 5-2. Bhagyashri, there's Sunita Munda onto her. Sunita Munda wins it. Martina. Priyanka, excellent trickery. Priyanka keeps going. That was poked towards Sunita. Clearance coming in. Shanmugapriya. Excellent lofted pass. Arrows. Plenty of blue shirts in and around that area. They always go up in collective numbers, and there is a player available between two defenders. That is most heartening to see. That gives a clear indication of their attacking threat that the Indian Arrows possesses. And Irvan Shah knows his team got to close that gaps. And they were meant to clear those gaps. Lots of research being done by the PIFA management in putting up the squad. Champions of the Mumbai Women's League. Cross comes in from the right. An easy collection from Adrija. Now Aarti wins the header. Bringing the ball down with her chest. Apurna. Give and go. Could not be completed. Zairem. Managing things in midfield. Getting out of the tight space with smooth footwork. She's got quick feet. Sunita Munda. Priyanka Devi ahead of her. Sunita Munda cuts in to her right. And the shot is not the one to remember. Parmila. And Arrows almost losing the ball inside their own half. Martina, she is dispossessed. Zairem looking for that breakaway move. It's PIFA. Santosh measuring this. She was forced to go long. Holding things well in midfield. Forcing the Arrows to take the aerial route. PIFA are aware of the fact that Indian Arrows can pass the ball round brilliantly. Pass the ball with a lot of urgency. And the only way to stop the opposition from moving the ball around quickly is by getting physical, is by closing them down. Priyanka finding Parmila, the right back. A ball from deep, beautifully brought down. Sunita Munda. The last touch not so satisfactory. She brought it down perfectly though. Priyanka. Gets the one touch going with Martina. And this is Aarti. On the overlap is Parmila. Will she get there? She won't. Eventually the number 4 of PIFA gets there first, and that was Afreen. So the first quarter of an hour gone here at the Capital Ground. It's still nil-nil between the Indian Arrows and PIFA. Muskan finding space to her left. I can't find the right pass though. In the 2021-22 season, the Indian Arrows is one of the that featured an extended format where 12 teams fighting it out in a round-robin format. Another new element to the league this season is the Arrows. We have seen the men's team compete in the I-League and later supply the senior men's national team with a number of talented players. Now the women's team is also planning to do the same. It is important that the Indian Arrows women's team, and they play together in the Hero Indian Women's League consistently. Is basically a developmental team for the senior national team, as something that is essential for the ecosystem. And so a free kick. And Apurna Nursery was fouled by Sunita Devi. Ball sent in, escaped everyone, and almost going towards Santosh. Now the flag went up immediately. Now this game is certainly lacking in pace. Now the previous one was slightly end to end. Priyanka and Martina, they have previously played for the senior women's team, with the former even scoring her maiden senior international goal against Egypt a couple of months back. And it's always a positive when you have players with international experience. They pass on that experience to the other girls who are new as well. And these players are guiding the others, and that's always good for the team. Parmila takes it short, sends it in, comfortable. Martina, Indian Arrows trying to reinforce their supremacy in this game, still in search of the first goal. Santosh takes route one. Apurna Nursery leaving it for Priyanka from a tight angle. An excellent block as well from Sunita Devi. It was perfectly timed, even though the angle was against her. Heading it down. Now Aarti, a sliding challenge, got to stop it from going out. And she delivers a cross towards the near post. Keeper fumbles. It's touched out for a corner. And Apurna Nursery, she's got her hands on her head. And goal kick taken short. and just scanning the environment, trying to read the game and then react accordingly. Looks slightly scrappy down there in the middle, the arrows, and Martina Thokchom's diagonal ball is eventually going to find Priyanka, who will look to give a tough time to Mansi. Apurna Nursery, she is in a red hot form in this competition. And El Chadai, of course, is right there at the top when it comes to scoring goals with 15. And Manisha Kalyan is the second high scorer with 12. And Gokulam Kerala, they will be taking on Sports Odisha tomorrow at 3:30 p.m. At 8 a.m., pardon me. 3:30 p.m. Sethu Madurai will be in action. It's going to be a very crucial day tomorrow. The Arrows project certainly focusing on building for the future while giving the talented players regular playing time in the domestic league. Right up there you can see the referee assessor. This is Aarti. Arrows looking to rebuild. Plays it square to her defensive partner, Shanmuga Priyash Shashi Kumar. Shashi Kumar shaping up for a long pass. It's a neat ball into Priyanka. First touch letting her down. Cleared away by Bhagyashree. Won back by the Arrows. This is Pushpa Rani. A nice turn. And then shoots Muskan Priyanka Devi. Arranging it, she waits, watches, and delivers a cross. That is towards nobody. Mansi with the throw-in. Priyanka's header. Aku collects. Muskan challenges and she wins it as well. The transition from attack into defense for the Arrows is something they'll have to improve on. A challenge from behind. A standing tackle from Martina and a free kick for PIFA. Aku with the free kick. Goes direct. Oh, what a strike! Wonderful from the number 10. An absolute stunning strike. And everyone present there on the field of play didn't really expect that going in. And no one saw that coming in, tell you what. And flying kisses. From the bench. That's a dream goal for the number 10. and one of the best goals of this competition, without a shadow of doubt. A beautifully executed free kick. Just wow. And now PIFA in the lead. We'll try and have a look at the goal once again. This is the Arrows now. They are trailing. They're down by a goal against PIFA. And against a run of play from free kick. Aku are converting the chance directly. Karen plays it forward. There's the covering defender from Shashi Kumar. Now look at that. From almost 35 to 40 yards out, keeper went slightly advanced, just had to backtrack. Not been able to maintain her balance. Deceived by the flight, and that is how it's went in. Right up there, the top corner. And the PIFA, they really needed something special to beat Drija. And pulling off a very special strike, Aku. She also scored against ARA Football Club. That was an 1-1 equalizer. The game, both the teams shared spoils. Arti. It's a very tight defense from PIFA. And now at the Arrows, who will come all out in search of that equalizer. And it will make the game a lot more interesting. Let's see if there is any balance between defense and midfield to how the Arrows play. By not panicking under the pressure. Just above the center circle, Apurna. Finding Sunita, asking for it is Apurna Nursery. Clearance from Santosh. The Maharashtra-based PIFA Sports Club marking their debut in the 5th edition of the Hero Indian Women's League. There's the shot coming in, and trouble for the goalkeeper Pyle. It's kept in play expertly by a red shirt, and now it's been played outside. And so at the drinks break here at the Capital Ground, it's Indian Arrows 0, PIFA Sports Club 1. And that particular free kick really is the difference maker between these two teams. A lot of blame could be put on the young goalkeeper Adrija, but she was completely deceived by the bounce. Probably wasn't expecting that kind of a shot to come from 40 yards out. As Suren Chetri will be slightly animated, and Nirvan Shah very calm and composed, because it's his side who are in the lead. And that was the goal. You keep lying. You keep likes watching this time and again. Oh, just utilizing the wind blowing around the pitch. Beautiful technique applied. Use the outside of her right boot. And the ball just dipping towards the end, managing to hit the target. So almost at the half an hour mark, it's the Indian Arrows 0, PIFA Sports Club 1. That is Suren Chetri discussing her plans with Priyanka. And Nirvan Shah asking his girls to fight till the end. Still a lot of time left. You do not want to commit the same mistake like what the Odisha police did earlier in the day against SSB Women Football Club. Players are getting hydrated at the same time, almost as if a tuition class is going on with Suren Chetri and giving lecture to the players. And all the blue shirts very, very attentive. Having won the Maharashtra Women's League with local players, the team was reinforced with few outstation players. These players gelling well to play as a team, and they are focused on their business and are working hard with fitness. Coming the business end of the league, it's a great experience for these players. They will want to take learnings from such tournaments and apply them. To the structure in the state league system. Struggling to get the feel of the ball, PIFA. The Arrows are very, very comfortable with keeping possession. And they are good on the feet, which is why they've got good technique, and that goal coming against a run of play. The Arrows once again deciding to rebuild through Adrija. Santosh, good distance, brought down by Apurna Narzari. Apurna Narzari sliding it to the left. As I spoke about how this game is just one goal away from becoming entertaining. That's a high ball above Apurna Narzari. Sunita Munda not allowed to turn. Bhagyashri was alert to the danger. PIFA, and they are feeling the pressure of playing in a competition of much bigger altitude. The players are getting exposed to this kind of tournament, rubbing shoulders with some of the stalwarts of the country when it comes to women's football. Bringing it down for Apurna Nursery. The defender was well ready there. Zairem, below the halfway line, she's got a magical left foot. Calls up a yard to Nisilia. Mansi. Here comes Odisha Police. That is PIFA. And Odisha Police earlier in the day had to face a humiliation into the hands of SSB. That was a 5-2 loss. And Odisha Sports play tomorrow against Gokulam. As I keep mentioning the two home teams. And the arrows, they need just some kind of magic from the front four. Needs to get players involved more. This is Zaku, scorer of that wonder goal. Zairem, turning towards the left back, Mansi, is gone out for goal kick. And now finally into space is Aarti. And goes for that crossfield ball, Sunita Munda. Marshalled by Bhagyashree. Yet successful in going past Bhagyashree this evening. Sunita Munda. Santosh, she's been very, very consistent in defense for the Arrows. In the midfield three as well of Muskan, Priyanka Devi and Martina. With the number six, a bit of a mental block for the attackers. Player with excellent anticipation. Just drops into defense when required. Tallest player in the field of play as well. Corner taken short. Swung in towards the back post. Oh my word! Breathtaking stuff from PIFA. An absolute wonderful stuff. A massive curl at it. We saw a similar kind of a goal in the opening game as well of the day. From an Odisha Police player. And almost an action replay of that goal. And dipped towards the second post. And the goalkeeper was slightly baffled by the sun rays sparkling onto her eyes. As the ball goes right in. And it's 2-0 for PIFA. And Indian Arrows, they are shell-shocked. And that was the moment. And there's the curl. Oh. And there was Parmila present at the back post, but the ball just even going above her. And that was Nongbet with the strike. Both the midfielders firing so far in the first half for PIFA. It's going to be a wonderful result if they manages to hold on to this two-goal cushion against a strong Indian Arrows team. Beautifully worked again. There's that high ball. And Nisilia fired in a cross. Comes away with it, Santosh. Keeping a very cool and calm head. How do the Arrows respond now is the question. Do they have in them that character, that desire to bounce back? And when you are especially down by 2-0, it's all down to passion and character. As PIFA playing with a certain pep and zest, and that is bound to happen when you are up by 2. A throw-in taken long, given as a foul throw by the referee Kanika Burman. Hint of a handball, not deliberate. And now shot from distance from Aku. Wonderfully creating that yard. And goes for it and also managing to keep it on target. And that is the most important part. Two absolute world-class goals from PIFA. A very, very special stuff. Yeah, the Arrows still thinking where they have gone wrong. One scored from 35 yards out, and this one from the right flank went straight in. Zairem, she is quickly surrounded by blue shirts, and Indian Arrows, they've won it. Into their attacking half. Martina. Sunita Munda. She's been double teamed this evening. As PIFA denying Indian Arrows space on the flanks. It's a high ball. Apurna Nazari clashes with the goalkeeper. She got the touch. An excellent save from Pyle. Cross comes in once again. Under a lot of pressure, the number 4, Afreen. And this time the goalkeeper comes to the rescue in terms of bailing her teammate out. A certain desperation among the Indian Arrows players, as you can see. They're trying to hurry things up. And they got to be patient still. Another 45 minute coming their way. They desperately need at least a goal before going into the break. And that will very much keep them in the game. This is the number 12, Apurna Nazari. Trying to bulldoze her way through. Lots of covering defenders. They have studied these Arrows team, PIFA. Executing the plan to perfection. Going for man-to-man marking. And they are aware of the fact that Apurna Nazari is a very dangerous player. Yes, two of them taking guard of the Indian Arrows is number 12. Quick feed from Muskan. Fails to put it into a danger area. Additional time of 4 minutes. There are up to 7 players joining in attack when the Arrows go forward. And that also leaves a lot of gap behind for the opposition to exploit. And the wing play from PIFA this evening have been pretty decent. And quickly realizing that they can put the Arrows fullbacks and Pushparani and Padmila under potential pressure. If they try to overload the flanks and keep the remote of this game in the hand. He's struggling to join in attack. And the fullback so far there. Occupied each and every time. And up against Nisilia. Padmila is really having a very tough time. She is one of the top players in this season's Hero Indian Women's League. She already has proved her worth. By scoring goals in crucial moments. Shachikumar, Muskan, staying strong is Zairam on this occasion. Recovering the ball for PIFA, looking for the third one. Excellent guide on from Karen. Is Lalnoon Siami wide on the far right? Cross comes in. No pace on it. A minute and a half remaining in this half then. Muskan down the middle. Got to pick out Priyanka to the right. She goes to the left instead. Where Sunita Munda is present. She is up against Bhagyashree. Sunita Munda trying to get the better of the number 14 so far. The number 14 coming out on top. Staying closer to the number 11. And being a right footer herself. I can think exactly like Sunita Munda. That's been the advantage. She is quite aware of the fact Sunita Munda not so strong with her left. Forcing her to work it onto her weaker side. Those technical paths explained by the head coaches during training. They go through match videos and analyze the opponents. And all those expertise provided by the video analyst. And that's the halftime whistle then at the Capital Ground, and it's ended 2-0 in favor of PIFA. The side from Maharashtra, they go into the lemons break with the 2-0 lead with goals from Aku and Nongbet, and both the goals in fact absolute class, no questions about it. And the Arrows, they are trailing by 2-0. These are the first half stats. 62% of ball possession for the team in blue. 4 shots taken by both the teams and only 1 corner kick, and that is won by PIFA. The Arrows had the most of the ball, but they haven't been able to knock that door down yet. Only 4 shots taken in the first half. Arati with 1, Sunita Munda, Nauren, Priyanka, Mushka and Shubha. All of them with 1 each. the number of shots taken by PIFA. Bhagyashree, Aku with that sensational free kick from 35 yards out. And Isilia and Nongbet with one each. With limited resources, PIFA putting up a very strong show. Only four fouls committed by Indian Arrows. Arti with three, Martina with one. And these are the fouls. Only one foul committed by PIFA. Sunita Devi, the centre back, the number six, is on that list. And so the first half highlights between Indian Arrows and PIFA, match number 57. And the third game of the day here at the Capital Ground. The other one going on at the 7th Battalion. Early through ball for Karen. Had to come out. Adrija and then Nisilia on the second ball. Straight to the keeper. And that was the free kick. And that was the moment for PIFA. The keeper was taken by surprise. And that is how they opened the scoring in this game. And then Zairem setting up the number two. A corner was taken short. Lots of variety in the approach play, and then it went in. And Nongbet, a stinging attempt from the number 11. They've practiced it time and again on the training pitch. And so at half time, it's Indian Arrows 0, PIFA 2. Don't go anywhere. We will come back soon.
He's easy man, Karen.
I know. Oh, I got this. I got this.
Drop. That's it.
Very
that's
yeah.
It.
Go. Finally, gonna drop it.
No, it's over the brim. It's gonna fall.
Oh!
Easy. 8, 25, 10.
10 push-ups.
Yeah!
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
बहुत बड़ा अपॉर्चुनिटी है उड़ीसा के लिए जो हम अभी डेवलपमेंट के बारे में सोच रहे हैं या कर रहे हैं लड़की लोग के लिए एक बहुत बड़ा IWL एक बहुत बड़ा प्लेटफॉर्म है जहाँ पे 60 गर्ल्स को चांस मिल रहा है एक साथ बड़ा बड़ा मैच खेलने के लिए बाहर में जो बड़ा बड़ा क्लब है उन लोग के साथ मैच खेलने के लिए एक बहुत बड़ा अपॉर्चुनिटी है और उसके साथ जो बाकी जो उड़ीसा के बच्चे हैं 60 के बाद वो लोग भी इंस्पिरेशन मिल रहे हैं उन लोगों को कि उन लोग IWL के थ्रू वो लोग आगे उन लोग का लाइफ कैरियर बना सकते हैं फुटबॉल में एक बहुत बड़ा अपॉर्चुनिटी है उड़ीसा फुटबॉल के लिए
सबसे पहले मैं हमारा गवर्नमेंट ऑफ उड़ीसा और AFF को धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगी कि दोनों ने मिल के ये जो इधर IWL का प्लेटफॉर्म किया है इसमें से हमारा जो उड़ीसा के 60 गर्ल्स इधर पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे हैं बाकी दो तीन क्लब में भी थोड़ा बहुत प्लेयर्स हैं तो ये उड़ीसा फुटबॉल के लिए फ्यूचर के लिए जो लड़की लोग खेलने के लिए आते हैं उनके लिए ब्राइट फ्यूचर है क्योंकि इधर इन लोग को इंडिया टीम के प्लेयर्स के साथ सीनियर इंडिया टीम जूनियर इंडिया टीम के प्लेयर्स के साथ खेलने को चांस मिला है ये प्लेयर्स आगे जाके नेक्स्ट ईयर में वो लोग दूसरा दूसरा क्लब में खेलेंगे और नेशनल टीम के लिए भी ये लोग जाएंगे मेरे को इतना होप है कि हमारा प्लेयर्स के पास इतना एबिलिटी है वो लोग नेशनल टीम में भी जा सकते हैं तो इनके लिए बड़ा प्लेटफॉर्म है सब क्रेडिट हमारा स्पोर्ट्स डिपार्टमेंट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ उड़ीसा AFF को जाता है।
मुझे ऐसे फील होता है कि जो बच्चे लोग हैं उन लोग अभी फर्स्ट टाइम ये लोग पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे हैं, उन लोग के लिए ये पूरा अलग दुनिया है। और इन लोग यहाँ पे जो अकोमोडेशन मिला है, जो ग्राउंड मिला है, उन लोग कभी सोचे नहीं थे कि ऐसा फैसिलिटी मिलेगा करके, क्योंकि वो लोग जो भी उड़ीसा के बच्चे हैं वो लोग सब गाँव से हैं, वो ट्राइबल एरिया से हैं, उन लोग के लिए ये पूरा अलग दुनिया है। वो लोग बहुत सारे बच्चे हैं जो कि ये सब फैसिलिटी देखे नहीं थे, उन लोग के लिए वो लोग बहुत एंजॉय कर रहे हैं और ऐसा ग्राउंड में खेलने के लिए मौका मिल रहा है उनको, वो लोग बहुत एंजॉय कर रहे हैं इसको।
आज आप जो बोल रहे हैं उड़ीसा को इंडिया में स्पोर्ट्स हब या स्पोर्ट्स कैपिटल बोल रहे हैं, तो इसका क्रेडिट सब गवर्नमेंट ऑफ उड़ीसा को जाते हैं, हमारा CM नवीन पटनायक सर को जा रहे हैं, क्योंकि सिर्फ फुटबॉल में नहीं, आप जैसे बोल रहे हैं कि अंडर 17 वर्ल्ड कप आ रहा है और बहुत सारा टूर्नामेंट इधर होगा, सिर्फ फुटबॉल में नहीं, हॉकी है, एथलेटिक्स है, रग्बी भी हुआ है पहले, अभी आगे बहुत सारा दूसरा इवेंट में भी बहुत सारा इंटरनेशनल नेशनल इवेंट इधर होगा। और इधर जो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर हर गेम में है, आगे जाके जो भी प्लेयर उड़ीसा में स्पोर्ट्स को करियर करने के लिए चाहते हैं वो लोग, उनका पेरेंट्स अभी से बोल रहे हैं हमारा बच्चे इसी स्पोर्ट्स में करियर करेंगे, एक पॉजिटिव साइन है। क्योंकि पहले जब हम लोग खेल रहे थे तब इतना फैसिलिटीज नहीं था, अभी जैसे फैसिलिटीज मिल रहे हैं बच्चों को, इतना स्कोप मिल रहा है आगे जाने के लिए, डेफिनेटली उड़ीसा स्पोर्ट्स और आगे जाएगा।
हम तो अभी IWL के लिए अलग अलग क्लब में साइन ही है, लेकिन हम लोग चाहते हैं कि वुमेन्स फुटबॉल और डेवलपमेंट करें, जैसे कि अभी हम लोग लगे हुए हैं, बाकी पहले इतना फैसिलिटी नहीं था, अभी जो फैसिलिटी सब मिल रहा है उस वजह से हम सोच रहे हैं कि आगे श्योर कुछ अच्छा रिजल्ट होगा और अच्छा वुमेन्स फुटबॉल में भी अच्छा फ्यूचर होगा।
जैसे कि मैम ने बताया, आगे सिर्फ हमारा, मैं फुटबॉल के बारे में बोलूँगी, हमारा गवर्नमेंट ऑफ उड़ीसा, फुटबॉल एसोसिएशन उड़ीसा, स्पोर्ट्स डिपार्टमेंट, सबको ही मिल के कैसे वुमेन्स फुटबॉल को आगे लेना है, डेवलप करना है। इसीलिए अभी फर्स्ट टाइम जो 60 प्लेयर्स हैं, आगे जाके हम लोग कैसे हमारा नेशनल इंटर स्टेट में हर एज ग्रुप में हम लोग अच्छा रिजल्ट करें, चैम्पियन हो के मैक्सिमम हमारा प्लेयर्स हर एज ग्रुप में ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा नेशनल टीम में उस सब कोशिश कर रहे हैं। उसके साथ कोचेस भी ट्राई कर रहे हैं कि अच्छा प्लेयर प्रोड्यूस हो उड़ीसा से, तो ऐसे अगर चलता रहेगा तो डेफिनेटली एक दिन उड़ीसा का मैक्सिमम प्लेयर नेशनल टीम में प्लस हर क्लब में जो प्रोफेशनल क्लब है बड़े बड़े क्लब में खेलेंगे।
And welcome back to the second half, and you're watching the Hero Indian Women's League 2021-22 live on Eurosport, and the matches are also streamed on the YouTube channel of the Indian football team. It is match number 57 between PIFA and the Indian Arrows, the side from Maharashtra leading by 2-0 at half-time. And in case you are here, spread the word in social media. The matches are live on the YouTube channel of the Indian football team as we get ready with the second half action. A change took place as well, as the number 25, as we can see, of the Arrows, Priyanka, has come on. Just trying to strengthen the midfield, the Indian Arrows. PIFA is going to be a long, arduous 45 minutes. They will look to protect this 2-goal cushion. This is really going to be very, very difficult, because Indian Arrows going to come out all guns blazing in the second half. And they've got a lot of quality in the lineup. In each and every department, they've got a leader present. Just 1 goal from here on can bring the Blue Tigress back in the game. Will they succeed or not will be answered in the next 45 minutes. Yeah, the referee Kanika Burman taking her time. And the first half goals are from Nongbet and Aku, the number 10. Both of them world class strikes. They really needed something special against this Indian Arrows, and they have scored two very special goals. Those two will be remembered for a long, long time by the football fans. And we are underway with the second half, and the team in blue, Indian Arrows, will be operating from the right to left of your screen. And the team in red, PIFA, will be protecting their goal to the left. Arrows in possession, plays a long ball forward, the central defender. This is Priyanka, checks back onto her left foot. It's a high cross, an early chance for Apurna Nursery. The flag went up. Let's have a look. That was Sunita Munda. And the flag immediately going up against the number 11. She was flagged off. A wayward pass. Interception from Parmila, the right fullback. Tucking in slightly. It's a very narrow system from the Arrows. A Pushpa Rani. Didn't work out the give and go. And nicked from behind. A free kick for PIFA. A lot to play for in the second 45 minute. Indian Arrows, they have a the third spot rising like a hopeful spire in front of them. A win will take PIFA to 14 points. They will remain a sixth though. And they have won three matches so far. The victory in the last game came after five matches. And now they got to make it a habit of winning games. That is Priyanka making a run up top. Priyanka from the right corner of the penalty area. Can't get her cross in, twisting and turning. Buys the yard, in comes the cross, goes up for the header. Sunita Munda has bundled it over. And it's 2-1 for the Arrows. A perfect start to the second half. And they have nicked a goal back. An excellent change from Suren Chetri. And that was a master stroke, bringing on Priyanka. She made a decoy run. Drifting onto the flanks, then the body swerve, creating half a yard, and the dipping cross towards Sunita Munda. Keeper spilled it. The number 11 was very, very quick to react. And she makes it 2-1. And now we have a game on our hands. Indian Arrows just beginning the second half. In a breakneck pace. Shashi Kumar. I couldn't get it over Aku. She got in the way. Santosh, Martina, again goes long, headed away by Afreen, Zairem, skipping past a couple of challenges and spreading it to the left, and now Martina Thokchom, goes for the overhead pass. Attempted flick on from Priyanka, slipping in Apurna Nursery. Very quick touches from the Arrows and shot from Priyanka. And that was a rasping attempt. Goes sailing over the bar. An excellent build-up. A short passing build-up from the Indian Arrows. They are here to prove their mettle as a team. And they will look to go gung ho, especially out wide. Martina with a neat interception. There's a Apurna Nursery away from one, setting up Priyanka. A weak right footer. And the keeper hugging the ball to chest. Nongbet, the scorer of the second goal, looking to take on Pushparani. And not managing to do so. A cut out by Aku before the ball could reach Priyanka. Bhagyashri Aku. Mansi. The last 40 minutes tell you what gonna be very, very interesting. And Indian Arrows, they've got a lifeline here. Muskan, Priyanka, on the overlap is Parmila, and looking for that quick 1-2, well seen by Afreen. And now Priyanka opens up her body. A deflection in place. Sunita Munda. On the overlap, Pushparani. She's got a tracker alongside in Nongbet. Gets a foot in. A throw in for the team in red. PIFA. Muskan. Challenge on Lalnunsiami. Takes it over the top. And those tall physical players of the Arrows present are quite comfortably dealing with the aerial balls. And Nongbet away from the number 20 and almost falling short of Pushparani. Muskan dropping deep, adding another extra force in alongside Martina. She's gone forward. The chop and change. And when Muskan drops deep, Martina goes forward. And the vice versa. Nursery. Turning away from the number 6. Nursery again. I cannot go past Afreen. Santosh. Priyanka jumps over the challenge. Trying to flick it over. Parmila. Karen Pius. Still Karen Pius. No support inside the box present. She was almost forced to take that shot. Zairem snatched away by Muskan. Priyanka, she's been a fresh air in this Arrows lineup in the second half. Beautifully done. And Sunita Munda getting her shot away through the legs of the number 14, Bhagyashree. Still looking for that equalizer. And they got to get it as soon as possible. There's a reverse ball from Priyanka, getting the shot away, finding that gap between the legs of Bhagyashree. Sunita Munda. Muskan. Pushparani. Away from Muskan. Zairem. Getting involved. Karen Pius. Backing into Martina. Again, that physical presence coming into play. You just cannot go past. She is like a wall in the heart of midfield of the Arrows. And does all the blockings, breaks up her play. Priyanka wins it high. Priyanka onto her left foot. And that was quite ambitious. And the Indian Arrows slowly and steadily getting into the mood. And there's Nirvan Shah. And down the line for Karen Pius. She's got a player running inside her in Lalun Siami. Karen Pius keeps going. Gets the cross in. A clearance from Shashi Kumar. Could have fallen to a red shirt. Thankfully, Santosh. At the right place, the right time. Priyanka now between the two strikers. Tried to thread it for her namesake. And the game just starting to heat up a bit in the second half, and the defense primarily designed for attack, and in the event both the fullbacks opting for the overlap at the same time, and the team is left exposed with only three men at the back and two defenders and the central defensive midfielder, and daunting down the left, Nisil Lalun Siami. Wonderful footwork, tricks past the marker, and saving it with a feed this time, Adrija. What is happening here with the arrows? Look at that, extended foot from Santosh, doesn't get the ball. Losing her player. A very clever footwork there from Lalun Siami. That is what she is capable of. Pushparani coming central from wide position. Getting caught out there to Karen Pius. From the central circle. Tried to play it forward. Intercepted by the number 4. Parmila. This is Santosh Parmila. Apurna Narzari. She's got Priyanka up top. And Naurim, also providing that support, is Priyanka. Wonderfully done by Priyanka. Another teasing delivery. This time, hits the side netting. Priyanka's inclusion just bringing that extra pace. Bringing that mobility up top, which was lacking in the first half. Apurna Narzari, almost falling for Priyanka, breaks for Naurem. Just at the hour mark here at the Capital Ground, it is the Indian Arrows 1, PIFA 2. Still dominating the team in blue in terms of keeping the ball. Looking much more composed now after getting in that first goal. There's the strength of Martina coming into play. Muskan, and out of her reach, has been retrieved by Yaku. She's got a fantastic feed, and what a ball for Lalun Siami. She has got Karen Pius for support. Lalnun Siami again turns away from Santosh, setting up Karen, surrounded by three blue shirts. Out wide for the number 11 in the side footed attempt. Here's the side netting. Nongbet was the player. And what a move from PIFA. Excellent display from the side from Maharashtra. Just outfoxing the Indian Arrows defense. A lot of quick feet up top. Had that beat on target would have been really very challenging for Adrija. Constantly keeping the fullbacks under pressure. Nisilia, I haven't seen much of her this evening though. Had a terrific game against Odisha Police. This is Priyanka, goes on the outside, Priyanka, blazing it over the top. That was a fine chance for the Arrows for an equalizer. They're getting closer. Got to make the decisions right. Suren Chetri, by his facial expression, one can surely make out that he is not happy. Got to take the responsibility up top. Zaire Zairem. Down the line for Lalnun Siami. Siami tricking past a couple of challenges and now she is on her scooter down the left. Martina tracking back, getting a foot in. Yes, trickles out of play for a corner. A corner taken shot. Swinging it in. Gonna be another corner. Back to back corners for PIFA. And that was the moment. Oh, clattering off the woodwork. And the follow through goes over. What a moment from PIFA. Getting the shot away. That was Martina's header. Not too far, and then on the rebound. Onto the second ball, Karen Pius. Hitting the crossbar. Martina hitting her own player in the way. And now she apologizes. Aku shaping up for a long ball. Headed clear by Parmila. Collected by Priyanka. Martina again. Number 25, Priyanka. From a central position. One way then the other, Sunita Munda. She was stopped on her tracks. Pushpa. Goes high. Apurna Narzari bringing it down. Here is Naurem. Still with Naurem. A chase on from Sunita Munda. And she eventually gets there before Bhagyashree. And Indian Arrows hot on the heels of the team in red. Carrying it forward. She's been allowed to put in those diagonals. Nothing comes from it. And the stretcher is out. Mistry comes in for Bhagyashri. PIFA making those changes. Two more getting ready. Play restarts after a slight abruption due to an injury. And the concerned player is stretched out. There might be a shooting chance. I'm just trying to find that inch, the arrows. Missilia. This is Karen. Mystery. Beautifully cut off by Shashi Kumar. Arrows keeping the ball well. They are still in search of that equalizer. And then they have to take the lead. And they cannot settle for anything less than 3 points to give the chase on, to give a tough fight, to kickstart up top. PIFA will be extremely happy with the way things are going so far. They're relying on the counter and almost nicked in the third one. But the crossbar coming to the rescue for the Arrows. And the keeper could only see that, striking the crossbar and say a little player prayer. Lalnun Siami. More the number nines getting involved. And now accelerating is Nisilia. Nisilia comes onto her right side. And the ball is aimless. Shanmuga Priya with the clearance. Aku from distance. Just striking Muskan. It's recovered by Apurna Narzari. And now Naurem from the right. Rolls it down the line for Priyanka. Priyanka got a couple of blue shirts steaming inside the box to aim at. Her attempted pass. Straight into the feet of here is Priyanka again. It's a high cross and almost an action replay of that goal scored by Nongbet. And in the day, the crosses from that part of the pitch are really troubling the keepers going in. It might be a lucky side for the teams, aren't they? We saw in the opening game and in this game as well. It's dipping in. Maybe the air is favoring. Thank you. the Arrow side really progress, focusing on their progressive development. And at the end of the day, they want the girls to play good progressive football in the future. It's always positive to have players with international experience, and they pass on that experience to the other girls who are new as well. And these players are guiding the others, and that's always good for the team. Martina. Slotting into that hole in front of a defense. Stays lower on the pitch. Provides that cushion and makes loads of interception due to her excellent anticipation. She can read the game and pick out passes at the right time in important areas. She almost scans the entire game. She's got the strength and that ability to play the role of a destroyer, to play the dirty role. Mystery, she is planning for a long throw-in. An arrow towards Karen. Pushparani putting it out for another throw-in. That zing from the Indian Arrows' play suddenly gone missing. Yes. The PIFA team slowly getting into the game. It's certainly and not been the day of the team in blue. Still trailing by a goal and 16 minutes of regulation time left. And now they have a corner kick to defend suddenly. Due to sloppy defending. Martina. And they got to quickly move the ball away from this area. Nadrija got to hurry things up and she releases Parmila. Parmila carries it forward for the Arrows. Apurna Narzari, a dummy from Priyanka, tried to play in quickly to Naurem. And there's that pass from behind. Too much power onto it from Martina for Shanmuga Priya. A throw in taken quickly. Apurna Narzari. Double teamed once again, outnumbered. And now time for the second hydration break of the day. The sun is ready to set behind a high rise here. A cool breeze blowing across the pitch. The weather now much forgiving. It's all about holding on to this lead. Indian Arrows, they have 14 minutes. And that's the instruction from the assistant coach. To be patient. And Nirvan Shah also barking out instructions. It's going to be a huge result for them if it ends this way. Thank you. There's Nirvan Shah, as you can see, very, very animated. Suren Chetri just showing something in the areas they got to target. Things have not gone according to his plan. It's a wonderful chance for PIFA to upset the Arrows, to upset their dream run. Very headstrong and staunch in his way, Nirvan Shah. And so Sanghi comes on for Zyrem. The number 27. Pushparani Chanu also makes way for Ritu. To lift it over the defense line, and now Martina. Aggressive play from the number 6. As she's got the license to go forward slightly because Muskan is sitting deep. And just robbed of the ball. Lalnun Siami. She's seen the gap on the left and plays it into the path of Nisilia. Twisting and turning and going past the challenge. Nisilia with a low ball. Might be a chance for Nongbet. Oh. Once again, a wasteful in front of goal, PIFA. I could have nicked in the insurance goal. And all those build-ups, all those counters. A lot more swift from PIFA. Nisilia plays it in field. A cut off by Martina. Adrija goes long. Mystery. Regulation time of last 10 minutes. It was a ball from deep. Stood sturdy there. Shashi Kumar. Priyanka. Miscued clearance. Can they capitalize? Now they're maintaining that shape pretty well. PIFA. In terms of creating chances, not a great day for the Arrows. Instead, PIFA, they are looking promising. A couple of gilt-edged chances, and this player, Lalnun Siami, at the center of things. She's got the quality up top to do the damage. Same as this player, Apurna Nursery. Away from one, as if she did not exist. A certain calmness Apurna Nursery adds in her gameplay. A very cool and calm player. Makes things look so simple. Priyanka getting into a crossing position. The left full back was too close to her. Santosh with the ball from deep towards Priyanka. Good goalkeeping from Payal. High boot. A referee could have played the advantage. She calls back play instead. A free kick for Indian Arrows. And we've seen a wonderful goal from free kick in the first half. Aku scoring from 40 yards out. And now it's the turn of Santosh to return the favour. Can Indian Arrows get the equaliser? Takes it to the right. It's a high cross. Keeper is nowhere near to goal. And now opened up for Shanmugapriya. Shanmugapriya goes for the curler. Has gone out of play. And Naurim was present at the far side. A wonderful chance for the Arrows here. And Pyle missing the ball altogether. And that was the moment, as you can see. Comes off Priyanka, Shanmugapriya. Cutting inside onto her right foot. Tried to curl it from the second post. Martina's header. Away from PIFA defense again. Lalnun Siami guiding it towards Nisilia. And those two Northeasterns will look to combine. A decent challenge from Santosh. And now they'll take their time. Trying to steal a few important seconds here. A regulation time of 6 minutes remaining. An early goal from the Indian Arrows in the second half, we all thought. We are in for an absolute cracker. Since then, the team in blue have gone off the boil. Still time remaining though. Parmila with the cross in. Perfectly set up for Priyanka. It is squeezed in. The flag went up. The goal won't count. That was the moment for the Arrows, and Priyanka pokes it towards goal, squeezing it in. She was marginally offside. Now hustled off the ball, snapping into a challenge. Another high ball, questions will be asked on this occasion of the PIFA defense. And they comes out with flying colors. The last couple of moves from the Arrows, really very dangerous. And this player, she has been impressive since she's come on. From the beginning of the second half, I tried to make a lot of things happen in the final third. And suddenly the PIFA defense have a new player to mark who can add a lot of pace, can drift out wide into the channels. Ritu Muskan. Now Priyanka is on the run. Priyanka! And that heavy touch. Now Rem, Parmila, Apurna Narzari, joining forces in attack is Muskan, away from the challenge, towards Priyanka. Not that much distance on the clearance. This time it's far enough. Sasi Kumar playing it all the way behind to Adrija. Santosh. Those two holding fort at the back. PIF, they've got Lallun Siami up top. Beautifully won by Yaku. Apurna Nazari lays it up for Naurem on the right hand side, asking for Nazari to stay closer. There's the cross straight to the keeper. Santosh scanning the environment and finding Apurna Nazari. Nice one touch build up. It was looking menacing down the right. Just a minute and a half remaining of the regulation time. There's going to be added minutes. Expecting a handsome amount of added minutes. It seems like there's going to be a change in goalkeeper as well. Lot of work for the fourth official then. Two changes. And the additional minute as well. And so Anjali will come on and Payal will be taken off. That is the word. So Nirvan Shah just backing onto his experienced goalkeeper for the remaining minutes. Additional time of 5 minutes. Still a lot of time for the Arrows to salvage something from this game. Even a winner is possible. They need to score twice then. It's difficult but not impossible. And the Arrows simply just not playing up to their potential. Sometimes overdoing things in the final third. This is Naurem. Running out of options. And all those spaces beautifully blocked. Holding a very tight line. A PIFA in midfield. Crowding out the Arrows. Using their body shadow cover. And closing down the passing lanes. And that's going to be a clumsy challenge from Santosh. A free kick for PIFA. So finally, time for the change in goalkeeper. Lalreen Muani, it looks like, will also come on for Nongbet. A smart move from Nirvan Shah. Injecting a fresh pair of legs. Only 3 minutes remaining. Naku will be taking the free kick. She already did the obvious, the audacious rather, in the first half. Can she do it once again this evening? Incredible distance on the free kick, another decisive moment. Lalnun Siami went up for it. Brings a corner kick for PIFA. With about a couple of minutes remaining on the clock. They will take their time. Nisilia. Getting the return. There's the in-swing floor swerver towards goal mouth. Is deflected behind for another corner. Causing a lot of troubles with the set pieces, PIFA. In case going gets tough, the best way to harass your opponent is by working on set pieces, and that is exactly what they've done this evening. Lalrin Muani's cross. A goal mouth clearance from Santosh. Three corners in a row for PIFA. In search of the third goal. And the rub of the green not going Indian Arrows' way. Time is running out for the team in blue. This time it's a throw-in. A very clever play from Nisilia. Stopping it from going out for a goal kick. And it's Priyanka up top. Close to the danger was Mansi. And after her two wins in a row, this is going to be another defeat for the Arrows. Their third of this campaign. Even in their wildest of dreams, they must not have thought losing to PIFA. But that is the unpredictability which makes the Hero Indian Women's League so, so special. And so, so riveting over the course of the season. It's like a snake and ladder. It's like a chess played on a chessboard made of butter and chessmen of jelly. Let's see whose king falls first. And that's the full-time whistle. And PIFA will celebrate this victory. It's a big one for them. And their fourth of this campaign. And a win takes them to 14 points from 10 games. And for the Arrows, it is their third defeat. And the remains fourth. And now Kickstart Football Club can breathe a sigh of relief because their third spot is now quite guaranteed. Still, the last round remaining. It's a huge result for Nirvan Shah and his girls. Today's hero of the match is going to be Nongbet. She scored that second goal. It was a cross which went straight in. She must not have intended that. The luck of the day was lying with the team in red. And so Lal Nun Siami, she is awarded a cheque of 5,000 rupees powered by Hero Motor Corp Limited. This is Nong Bet. These are the match stats. 61-39. The ball possession, the arrows having all the dominance, but nothing to show for it. And despite getting an early goal in the second half, not managing to get the team over the line. Five corners won by PIFA, none by the arrows. A very surprising result. And 8 shots taken by the Indian Arrows in this game. Priyanka Nawrem with 3, Aarti with 1, Sunita Munda with 1, Apurna Narjali, Shanmuga Priya, and Muskan all with 1 each. And now we will have a look at the number of shots taken by PIFA in this game. They've taken 7 shots in fact. Nongbet with 3, Bhagyashri Dalvi with 1, Aku with 1. No further shots registered by her in the second half. Nisilia and Karen with 1 each. Now let's have a look at the fouls committed by Indian Arrows in this game. And I've committed 7 fouls. Aarti with 3, Sunita Munda with 1, Martina with 1, Parmila and Muskan, both of them with a foul each. And well, these are the fouls committed by PIFA. Zaku and Sunita Devi with 1 each. Now let's have a look at the goals of this game. This was the first one from Aku. 35 yards out. A majestic strike. And PIFS Football Club, they were not done yet. And this one from Nong Bet. What a fitting response. An absolute stinger. Indian Arrows pulling one back. Priyanka's cross, Sunita Munda. Quick to react. Pouncing onto that loose ball. And putting it into the back of the net. It did seem that Indian Arrows would bounce back into the game, but that never happened. And PIFA defended with a lot of grit and determination the remaining minutes of the second half. And so the full-time score at the Capital Ground is Indian Arrows 1, PIFA Sports Club 2. And thanks for joining us and goodbye from the Capital Ground.